My name is Athena Reich, and I was the Lady Gaga in tonight's show. I guess I took my first acting class when I was 9, but I started playing piano when I was 4, singing when I was 8, and I've been acting, singing, doing music in various incarnations as an actress, a singer-songwriter, all of that. And the Gaga thing was, I don't think anyone, like, maybe some people do set out to be impersonators from a young age, but I don't think so. It's something I fell into by chance. Gaga's Bad Romance came out, so I did a cover of it on guitar. And then it got a lot of views, and then this was in 2009, near the end of it. And then I just started getting people contact. Hey, can you do her show? I'm organizing a New Year's event. This was the first gig I got. I'm organizing a New Year's Eve event. It's gonna be 3,000 people in Washington, D.C. All the other Gaga impersonators, they don't sing. And you sing, and you kind of look like your kid, get a wig, put a costume, do a show for me. I was like, okay, fine. So like, I got 3 costumes together, I got hair, and I had to learn like 9 songs, and it was like way harder than I thought. I was like, yeah, I'll do this. I was like, oh my God, I was not even a Gaga fan. I was like, yeah, she's good, but I wasn't like, I had to like learn all of her stuff. My girlfriend at the time was like, you're not doing it right, because she was a Gaga fan. This is how she sings it. I was like, it doesn't matter. She's like, it does. And I'm like, oh yeah, you're right, because fans are expecting this certain ways. We made a video of that, put it on YouTube, and it was the first like Lady Gaga impersonator reel that was good, because she was still new on the scene. And so since then, I'm always on the first page of Google. So people, that's how the whole impersonator thing, and I just have so much fun doing it. I get a taste of what it would be like if I was my own rock star. So I just take whatever kind of fun performance opportunities I get, and this is like so fun to just get up and sing and work a crowd and connect with people through music. Pregnant at this point, so I was actually leading up to this, I was kind of like, honest, a little dreading it, like, oh, it's gonna be okay. My mom's like, you're always worried and it's always great, don't worry. I'm like, but I'm pregnant. She's like, you performed in your first pregnancy, we're fine. I'm like, yeah, I guess you're right. So and so she was right. My mom was always right.
My name is Carol Priest. It was a very different circumstance, and so my job is to have people on my radar. I can't know everybody, and about 2 years ago, Athena had sent me some information on herself. I thought, wow, that's fantastic. And I had it in my database, but I had a different performer booked to do the show. That performer fell ill, and I went in my database. I was like, why did I not think of this person in the first place? And so that's when a bad thing turns out to be the best thing, because I got the best person the job. I felt a little nervous about Athena being pregnant until I saw a video. So it was very, very fortunate and very professional of Athena to capture a video of herself performing at 7 months pregnant. So she was only going to be 4 months pregnant, or 5 months pregnant for our first show and 6 months for our second show. So I got to explain it to the client, who was very nervous, but it all went through. I thought tonight's performance was superstar. It was very thrilling. I was at the back of the house, so I could see everybody's involvement in the show. I got to see all the lighting. I got to see the magnificence of the dancers, and I got to see Athena rock the room. It was wonderful.
No matter what happens in this world, who tries to put you down, what dream in your heart you have to follow, no matter what, you keep your poker face.
With us. And Michelle told me that the rehearsal went great. They were really dedicated. For me, it's not just talent, but it's a lot about finding people with a really good attitude and we'll just kind of roll with it. And they gave me that energy tonight of just like, yeah, we'll just roll with whatever. So that's good.
Hi, I'm Matthew Eldracher. I've been a dancer for over 15 years now. I've been a performer since I was 4. When I dance with Athena, it feels like I'm part of the show. So it's great. The biggest challenge about this gig was that it was, we showed up and then it kind of just, everything happened so quickly, and I mean, that's showbiz. It kind of just rolled with the punches, and sometimes you end up on stage and you're like, I don't know what I was doing at that moment, but rolling with the punches, it works.
Hi, my name is Lianne Tammi. I've been dancing since I was 5, so it's been a while now. I started dancing competitively when I was a kid, and I went to Ryerson University for dance, and now I'm a part of the commercial dance scene in Toronto. So we got the videos sent to us through email, and because they've done the show a couple of times already, and we had to learn the choreography off the videos before the rehearsal. And then when we got to the rehearsal, it was just a matter of clarifying the details and making sure that we looked the same as the other dancers. And then when we arrived at the venue today, we were able to space everything with the other dancers and with Athena to make sure that everything was ready to go for the stage. There was definitely some last minute calls that I was like, okay, how's that gonna go? I'm not really sure, but we're gonna rock with it. And we really knew the choreography, so it was just a matter of really like listening to each other on stage and just going with the flow on that one. It's like a big difference dancing with an artist than it is dancing in like just a regular dance show, because you have to be very aware of the artist, because that is the central focus in the performance. So it definitely changes our focus and the way that we choose to perform.
She wants me to sit there.
Thank you. Was that not astounding? Was that not